Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Camera Tuesday. In today's episode we're gonna take a look at how to take your big ass DSLR and make them into a webcam. So we have to understand why there is such a need. First need is very simple. Webcams came into market way before there was an infrastructure to use them, as in like webcams can be found as early as 2003 to 2005. However, there was no internet infrastructure, no optical system, no 4G, not even 3G at that time. So we had the technology, but we had no way of using it, as in like even nowadays you can see people are like trying to make video call work, but you have to have very low ping, you have to make sure the connection does not drop in mid-con, but it's very difficult. Like you can see many people in YouTube doing live conversation while they are in a first world country, while they have optical system, but video quality still sucks. So webcam was kind of neglected because of this reason. Second, Windows flat out abandoned webcams. Like this is good thing about Apple, where they made sure the webcam, what they are putting on their laptop, was always as high quality as they can make them. Now of course the Apple laptops are ludicrously expensive, so they should have good camera, but if you buy a high-end laptop, as in Windows laptop, you may not get a very good webcam. So Windows flat out abandonment made sure there is 80% of the market does not have good webcam. Second, there is no mass production of webcams. Now many of you have seen nowadays how good, how crisp our mobile cameras have become. Like even camera as early as like 2-3 years ago from now was flawless, like, and the cameras that we are getting now, like it can almost compete with the DSLR. Now not in like pixel peeping way, but like overall you can sell a mobile camera image as in like, yeah, this is a good image. So but there is no mass production. Like the best mass produced Logitech webcams are barely produced in few million, while you can have something like Samsung Note K6 that was produced like roughly 45 million or 80 million some of the successful models. So there you see there is a reason why, even though there is technology that would allow us to make very cheap webcams at very high quality, because there is no mass production, we don't have it. So this is why our most of webcams suck. So what we can do about it? Now first thing, you have to check your camera, obviously. Now one thing you have to make sure before you follow this tutorial is that, does your camera have clean HDMI out? What does that clean means? Very simply, almost all cameras have HDMI. However, if you have a very cheap camera, it may not have HDMI out, as in live HDMI out. It might only be there for let's say you connect your camera to your TV and, you know, browse it. It's not there for like, you know, live screen recording. Second, all the on-screen display, like facial recognition screen, like where you see a square, a red button that is there for showing that it's recording, things like that should not pass through HDMI. Now some cameras have clean HDMI, some don't. So please, before you jump into this, make sure your camera, the camera you have or the camera that you want to use with it, have clean HDMI output. No, there should not be any on-screen element in the HDMI output. Second, you have to find a way to power the system, because webcams, like, you want to plug it and forget about it. You don't want to change batteries, and DSLR batteries are, while good for photography, they are nowhere near good enough for videography. Like for instance, I can barely shoot upwards of 1 hour in this Canon 800D. So for that reason, you have to make sure that you can power your camera externally. This is what we call dummy battery. Like all DSLRs, Canon and Nikon, even Sony, supports that. Sony has the advantage that you can directly plug USB and charge it. So not every Sony model, and please check whether does it support normal USB or it supports speed charging USB. So be mindful of that. Just do test about it. And you have to have this, then you connect it either with a big USB bank, like something like that, or you connect it via AC adapter. All companies sell you first party accessories like that, like Nikon has it, Canon has it, although they are ludicrously expensive. So these are the two core components. Does it have the output? Okay, check that. Second, do you have a way to power it? And if you don't, let's say you want to use GoPro, you have to be mindful. Can you rely on the battery to be there for like at least 2-3 hours? Like however long your session is, like let's say your sessions are barely 10-20 minutes and you only do one or two sessions in a day, battery is good enough. But I would suggest seriously to invest in some way to power it almost indefinitely. That's why I want to use AC power system for this sort of thing. okay, we got the camera down. Now, how do we actually make camera into a webcam? Now, you take the HDMI and you put it through USB 3.0. That is crucial. There are some older systems that will go from HDMI to USB 2.0, but they will barely support 720p. 720p at 30 frames per second, barely. So for that reason, you have to make sure it has to have USB 3.0. Now you might say Logitech webcams can somehow give full HD over USB 2.0. The reason for that is they have very good compression algorithm built into that. By mean good is just like, there is no other camera that can even do half of it. So Logitech is the only camera, like Logitech, there is a very specific Logitech camera model that is used by almost everyone, and every other camera is like laughable. So make sure you have 3.0, because your DSLR HDMI output, if it's clean output, it's a very, very large amount of data that's being pulled through. So you have to have USB 3. Then you come to make sure whether does it have audio transfer. Like this is Elgato Camera Link. Many people are complaining this does not transfer audio. Now that may be an issue, may not be an issue, but be mindful. Just check about it. And what I'm showing here is called capture card. These are very, this can also work as your like this. However, this has what's called HDMI output. So this was generally designed for a gaming system where you can use your, Sony PlayStation and send the data in. This will record it and send the data out to your screen. Now, this will not do that. This is just one way in. This has in and out. So for that reason, be mindful. If you want to, let's say you have a camera and you want to record it as a webcam, but you also want to make sure there is a physical display somewhere else, big display, or you are recording it for some other reason, you want to make sure that you want to go for this. So this is all you need for making your DSLR into a webcam. However, be mindful, at the end of the day, this is at least 3 to 4 times more expensive than Logitech camera, or you may find it is cheaper for you to have 2-3 webcams from different angles that may give you better stream quality. Like your stream will feel much more interactive if there is like, you know, different camera angles rather than one very good camera angle. So for that reason, be mindful of this. Not only these things are expensive, you have to be mindful how much expense you have to spend on making sure you can power your camera indefinitely. The HDMI cables are also not cheap. These things can cost upwards of like a smartphone price. So they're not cheap. So this was my small episode on how to make your camera into a webcam. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, don't worry about it. Dislike it and leave a comment what you want to see in the next episode of Camera Tuesday. And please subscribe. Press the bell icon as I make video every day. And as always, thanks for watching.